A woman spoke firmly, as she really knew that people was important for me. But I barely could think about Fräulein, whom I knew most, to stop to worry about a few people that I felt completely foreign to me. Luckily, I was able to focus enough to realize that the world that made me open the eyes was laying next to me with a shot in his head. The man that had killed the ward was keeping the gun eagerly inside his worn-out-at-the-elbows black jacket, and the women were too far to arrive in time. I closed my eyes and dreamt. It was a pity I wasn't able to plan the target. Maybe the final result would be the same. I either could brag about knowing what I was doing. It sounded resoundingly, making me wake up. My head, heart, leaned against the door. As I opened the eyes, the dizzy feeling kept me on the ground for a while. Sounded again. The room seemed familiar to me, even the confusion didn't let me place myself. I had to talk to you, Fräulein said from the other side of the door. Fräulein. I was back at the Chipiron's upstairs room. I still hadn't met Fräulein, and Damien had just run away in a hurry, afraid of the resistance caught to him. I know you are there. Open the door, Fräulein insisted with kind voice. I was trying to wake up, get up without losing my balance, think about being natural or not. Would it be better to pretend I didn't know him? Would it be the appropriate to tell him everything as soon as I saw him? Which one would the right reaction be? Please, open the door, it's important, Fräulein asked for. I moved away from the door, and I opened it at last. Fräulein's face, when he first saw me, dispelled all the previous second's doubts. It was that look, the look before he got mad at me when he thought I had used him to give Damien time to run away. I couldn't fight against the same feeling I had that day. I didn't want to, and I didn't feel like doing it. We have to talk, Fräulein said, getting dressed. I smiled. I couldn't help the déjà vu disorientation feeling, or maybe the relief one. The situation was very different from what I had left behind. Deep down, I was worried. Of course I was worried about people dying, especially if it was my fault or if they made me feel it was. On the other hand, it was still interesting I ended there, in time to remedy the perpetual Fräulein's anger, because just not to worry about it was taking too much place in my mind. I know, I answered with a smile on my face. I suddenly realized it was so pleasant to look at him without that eyebrow censoring everything. And how is that? He asked, surprised, raising his eyebrow, this time with an adorable expression. You are Fräulein, I'm Rita, and your word that brought me here and left so scared when he knew you are coming is Damien. I dropped. He looked at me, not understanding, without that obsession I remembered he had with the yellow ward. I had to tell you something, I began. As I was telling the story, a still relaxed Fräulein, overcome with amazement. He got up, he even smiled a bit. What a story! He exclaimed when I finished. If you hadn't told me some details difficult to deduce, I would think you are one of these they say they can see the future. Well, what you call see, I actually do, I laughed. I see, without attaching importance. Well, I suppose we'll make more progress if we start with the training right now. Or do you prefer going to the Torvalds? As they are going to have a hit. What's going on between you and them? I asked. Hey, if I didn't tell you the other time, I'm not going to do it now. We have more important things to think about. Have came back the serious Fräulein. I'm in favor of not repeating the mistakes from the first time, I said. Which are those mistakes? He asked. I told him all the truth. This time I didn't keep anything to myself, not even my dependence on him with the traveling thing, or the going to the very beginning plan. I had to talk to the others, he said nervously. I'd prefer you don't. I'm quite sure that's one of those mistakes I asked for. He looked at me, not angry, waiting my reasoning.